lived on the bayou. Only mode of transportation he had was this little old raft. And John would get on that little old raft, and he would paddle on down that river, that Mississippi River, Muddy Water River. So this is a little song we're going to do called Muddy Waters. And as John was paddling on down this raft, it's kind of difficult because John was a big, stout, strong man. But John would get his long stick and he would stick it in that muddy water and he would just push on off and take his time going down that Mississippi River. But if John were to speak to you, John would sound a little bit like this. Big old burly man on his poor little raft. But as John was going down this river, as he so often did, there's a little old house a little up the road, well, not the road, the river. And he would see the smoke coming up at the top. And John would know if he saw that smoke, that meant that it was a nice lady that he had met that was cooking some pies in her wood stove. Not the pies that you guys buy at Walmart, no. I'm talking about that homemade deep crust apple pie. That tasted a little different because it was cooked in that wood stove. We're kind of modernized now, so we don't know about stuff like that. But Miss Sheila used to always meet John at the river. And Miss Sheila would come out on the porch and say, I think she's talking to John. I don't know what she's saying right now. She's talking. She's speaking in tongues or something. What's that saying? What? You broke a string? Go on up. So Sally would give John his pie. Sally got a cold today or something. Don't know what's wrong with her. But John would go up the road. And it would just lay there for me, John. John a couple of snacks, some things to keep him tidy on the rest of his trip. Miss Bertha would go up and talk to John. Yeah, Bertha. Yeah, Bertha. That's that money giving music right there. Oh, $5, $10. So John would go on up the river and he would get to this little shack, a little broken down, but nevertheless, there would be musicians inside of this shack playing some nice blues. And John would jump off his raft and he would grab his saxophone named Betty. He loved Betty. And John would walk up in the shack with Betty and say, talk, Betty. keep talking. Go on, talk to him. Hey, we're listening. Nobody's up at the tip jar, but inside of this tip jar was always a piano player. That piano player was kind of special because he didn't bother anybody. He just sat back in the corner with his shades on and his nice hat. But when the piano player did say something, he would talk through his instrument. And Mr. Piano Player would say, before we get out of here. Y'all good? Yeah? I'm scared money don't make money. Here we go. Y'all give it up for the kid.